हेलो नमस्ते एंड अ वेरी हैप्पी फ्रेंडशिप्स डे. डू यू नो 82% ऑफ वॉट एवर इज लिविंग ऑन अर्थ आर प्लांट्स. प्लांट्स एज कम्पेयर टू एनिमल्स हैव गॉट मच हायर एबिलिटी टू रीजनरेट. दैट इज द एबिलिटी टू रीग्रो द सेल्स टिश्यूज एंड ऑर्गन्स एंड टू रिप्लेस द ओल्ड एंड डैमेज्ड वंस. प्लांट्स can therefore stay with you for a very very long time and they are your true friends for life. As a passionate plant lover, we all want our space to be abundance of green. There is nothing that makes us more happy than to see our plants grow bigger, healthier and also to multiply in number. Monsoons are the season of plant propagation. When you speak of propagation, there are many different methods from seed sowing to cutting, layering, crafting, budding, division, etc. Each of these methods will also have the unique do's and don'ts basis which the success rate of plant propagation could be high to low. As an urban gardener, we should always try and select plants which are more self-sustaining and also very easy to propagate rather than us investing time about the techniques and methods and do's and don'ts. Now what if I say that you don't have to read the correct propagation method preferred by your plant, rather your plant would do the hard work and almost self-propagate itself. Yes, you heard it right. Today we are going to speak of 7 plants which are very easy to propagate. They almost self-propagate themselves. So you just have to bring these plants once from the nursery or from the plant seller and they will keep self-multiplying themselves and would stay with you for years and years and increase in numbers like anything. Let's get started. But before we start this video, please do consider to subscribe, share and like so that the content reaches to maximum plant lovers. Also, stay till the end because in the end I would be sharing certain tips which will help you to identify such easy to grow and propagate plants which the professional gardeners of Mali would never share with you. And also there's a bonus plant in the end which is a surprise element. So keep watching.
Syngoniums, arrowhead plant or goosefoot. Most varieties are fast growing vine-like plants which will keep growing new shoots from all directions. They come in many variants from compact to bigger size and in different color shades. They grow best in medium sun to bright indirect sun. For faster growth and healthy plant, don't place it for too long in low light conditions. These plants grow best in temperature ranging between 16 to 30 degrees Celsius. Water when the pot soil feels dry to touch. These are humidity loving plants, so you can move them outdoors in monsoon. In temperature like that of Bangalore, they will do well even outdoors. But if you live in warmer areas and notice burning on the leaf, then you can shift them indoors. Alternatively, you can keep misting the leaves in the morning to increase the humidity level. Coming to the propagation, you can notice that the plant is sending out aerial roots. We can simply cut the stem from the node below the root and place it in soil. Also, you can grow it in water. And so, we can easily keep multiplying this. Keep an eye on the new growth to notice mealybug attacks because that is pretty common. As a preventive measure, keep spraying neem oil mixed with soap solution once in every 15 days. Turtle vine or inch plant, another very fast growing creeper, very popular for hanging baskets. This plant likes indirect sun and quickly covers the ground or pot you grow it in. Probably that's why we call it inch plant because it can be grown even from an inch of the cutting. Water this plant when you see the topsoil drying. Pest attack on the plant is extremely rare. Now if you observe the plant closely, each node is the point from which the plant gives new shoot growth. So each node produces tiny roots. You can just pluck from the nodal point and poke it in another pot and any pot which is kept in a shady area, and that would grow up into a new plant. So something like this, some cuttings have been put in this pot and in a few days it will fill up and start growing. Next on our list is Pedilenthus or Devil's Backbone, a succulent variety but a hardy one. So unlike other succulents, we can be carefree even when the weather changes. It does fine in summers, winters and rains. The dark green variety that we see here especially is a super hardy one. This is a sun-loving plant. If you stay in an area where the weather ranges between 15 degrees to 35 degrees Celsius, then you can keep it outdoors permanently. During the monsoons, skip manual watering and make sure that post the rains you drain out the excess water in the pot. The patterns that you observe on the stems are the nodes. So if you cut the stem from any of the node area, it would secrete a milky sap and you can directly poke it into a well-drained soil and the cutting method would give you 100% results. If you observe here, a lot of these cuttings while moving and shifting the plant were broken, so they were simply poked. Bryophyllum digremontaneum, mother of thousands or alligator plant. A difficult plant to pronounce the name scientifically, but very easy to take care and even easy to propagate. Another hardy succulent plant, provide this one too with 4 to 5 hours of morning sun. The roots of succulent plants are shallow, so I would recommend to let them be in the nursery pot and do not shift them frequently. Watering pattern should be medium during the summers. In the monsoon, let nature water it. Don't keep it open to sky because direct rain droplets might damage the plant. So a sunny balcony with the covered roof will be the best spot. With all other plants, we might have to cut and propagate the plant, but this plant does not even need that. The leaves produce small plantlets which has got roots and small leaves. So the winds keep placing them in the neighboring pots. Here, almost all the neighboring pots have got some alligator babies. We could pick these plantlets and place them in an assigned pot. And do not worry about this plant competing with the parent plant for the food because the roots are at the different levels. Persulanes and Portulacas, covering both these plants together because they are similar in nature for propagation and the plant care. If you love flowers, then these are the plants you can vouch for. A. They keep your garden filled with flowers from March to November so you don't miss the winter flowers. B. They produce such vibrant color flowers that they attract pollinators to your garden. And C. They keep almost self-multiplying themselves. A spent flower produces seed pods, so if you pop on or press the spent flower gradually, it will disperse the seeds to the neighboring soil and produce new plants. Speaking of the plant care, the only care it needs is good amount of sunlight. As compared to Portulacas, Persulanes can still flower in a medium or a daisy kind of day, but Portulacas need good direct sunlight to produce flowers. Now this one are some set of Portulacas coming in different colors, grown from seeds. And this one is a plant pot made out of cuttings from the Persulane plant. So if you notice your plant going leggy and increasing out of its length, just pinch it off and then poke it in the neighboring pot or any well-drained soil. And it will start growing a new plant and it will also start flowering in a very short time. So just within few weeks, you will see the next pot also completely filled up by this plant and flowering beautifully. So this way we can put it inside any well-drained soil and fill up more and more pots like this. Alternanthera. I have covered this plant in details in another video, the top 7 easiest plants to grow, so you can check out on the plant care if you consider having this plant in your collection. Today speaking only about the propagation, this is an invasive type That is, it spreads in the area it comes in contact with very quickly. This one was 1/4 of its size 6 months back, and now you can notice the change. The nodes on the stem have these roots coming out or sprouting out. So if you cut them and put it in soil directly or put it in water, it will grow firm roots. It doesn't need rooting hormone. You can grow out the cuttings directly in a pot soil. A well-drained soil should be used. This one was grown in water and it has grown nice roots. Marigold, another flowering plant in the list. A lot of us get these flowers during festivals, and the dried flowers will produce seeds which we can sprinkle in the soil and have new plants coming out of it. So you get a marigold plant once and it will automatically keep popping up in your garden. Give it good amount of sunlight, water it as soon as you feel the soil drying up, and fertilize it with any good general fertilizer once in 15 days. Marigold attract pollinators to your garden like honeybees. They are also used as pest traps. So many of the gardeners introduce marigold near the vegetable plants or the fruiting plants so that leaving them, the pest would attack the marigold instead. So keep checking for the pest attack. In case you notice any, then remove that plant part and spray with neem oil. Now the spent flowers can be just checked like this. These are the seeds. You can place them in the same pot so that new plants would also get ready. To my surprise, I saw one of the plant coming out in the soil bag lying. This one is the plant. I shifted it to the pot and it's turned out to be a healthy plant now. These are the saplings which has come out of these seeds. It has got maroon stem and these typical leaf shapes. As promised, the surprise plant for today is Hemigraphis alternata or purple waffle. So this is a beautiful plant. It was blooming today, so thought of sharing it and showing a glimpse in today's video. We might discuss it in a separate video although. So now the tip on how to identify easy to propagate plant is observe the nodal area of the plants closely. So in the nodal area, if you see the roots coming out, then it's an invasive plant and it will grow very quickly. You can divide it very easily and propagate it very easily. Plus, keep a check on the hedges and highway dividers, the airport or the commercial area landscaping. So the plant they use in the landscaping are very invasive and easy to multiply.
Hope you like this video. If you did, then please do like, share, subscribe, and do give your feedbacks in the comment section. And let me know if there's any particular plant or topic that you want me to speak of.